Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Kevin here. Recently, you watch some random YouTuber on the internet, and he tells you that by investing, you can become rich. And all of a sudden, you are interested to start investing, but you don't know how to buy stocks. In this video, I'll be giving you a step-by-step guide on how to buy stocks in Singapore. Starting from finding a stock brokerage, opening an account, and buying a stock itself. If you are only interested in certain topics, I'll leave the timing down in the description below so that you can jump straight to it. But before I proceed, if you are new here, do subscribe to my channel. I post every Monday talking about investing and credit cards and so on. Tap the bell button to get notified whenever I post a new video. And without further ado, let's start. Step 1. Finding stock brokerage. Before you can even start buying stocks, you need to first find a stock brokerage. A stock brokerage is a place where you can buy and sell stocks. And there are many stock brokerage in Singapore. That's why it is very important to find the correct stock brokerage, because it will be the place where you will be huating. Jokes aside, there are two reasons why you need to find a correct stock brokerage. First up is the fees. For every buy and sell that you make, you'll be paying a commission fee to the stock brokerage. And the brokerage in Singapore is charging anywhere between $10 to $28. If you chose the wrong stock brokerage, every trade that you make, you'll be paying a large commission to the stock brokerage. Now, you may think that $10 is very cheap, but for just $10, you can buy about 2 bags of heavyweight bathroom tissue. And that's a priority for some people, right? Second reason, depending on the stock brokerage that you chose, your stocks will be stored either in the CDP or a custodian account. Huh? What? CCP? Not CCP, it is CDP. Now, whenever you buy a stock, your stock has to be stored somewhere, right? CDP, or rather known as Central Depository, is a safe deposit for your stocks. An alternative to that is the custodian account. So instead of keeping your stocks in your own CDP account, your stocks is instead kept with the stock brokerage account. A stock brokerage that uses its own custodian account generally has lower commission fees. However, it comes with its own two problems. First up, if your stock is kept with the stock brokerage, what happens when the stock brokerage goes bankrupt? Then how? You may face some difficulties getting your stock back, or it may take a while before you can get your stocks back due to some paperwork. Another problem is, if your stock is stored in the custodian account with the stock brokerage, every time you need to sell the stock, you will need to go back to the same stock brokerage to sell. Whereas if your stock is stored in your own CDP account, any stock brokerage will be able to access this stock. For example, if you bought your stock using the DBS Vickers account, you can use the UOB account to sell your stock. So with this in mind, let's take a look at the stock brokerage comparison table by dollar and cents. Now, these are all the major stock brokerages in Singapore. So first up, we want to filter out all of the expensive stock brokerage, leaving only the cheap ones. We only have DBS, FSM1, Maybank, Phillips, Saxo, and Standard Chartered. You will notice that only DBS is using a CDP account. It is up to you which stock brokerage you choose from here on. But personally, with the downsides of using a custodian account I mentioned just now, I will personally use DBS Vickers. For the next few steps, I'll be using DBS Vickers as my example. Step 2. Opening an account. Now that you have chosen your stock brokerage, the next step is to open an account with them. If you are using a stock brokerage that uses a CDP account, you will first need to open your own CDP account. I'll be leaving a link to opening the account down in the description below. But if you are opening a stock brokerage that doesn't require a CDP account, then you can completely skip this step. For opening a brokerage account, you can just apply online. Just search in Google, then follow the steps listed to open the account. And once you have submitted all your documents, you will need to wait for a few weeks for it to be approved. So let's fast forward by a few weeks.
3 weeks later.
Step 3. How to buy a stock. Your stock brokerage is finally approved. Now, you are ready to buy your own stock. The next step is, I'm assuming you have money, right? Because that is how you buy stocks. So let's transfer some money into your own stock brokerage. As you can see, I'm already logged in to my DBS account. From here, I will need to go to Invest, More Investment Services, then click Top Up Cash to DBS Vickers account. Now, how much stocks you want to buy is totally up to you. You can even buy $10 worth of stocks, but take note that there is a minimum commission fee for every buy and sell that you make. You will want to optimize how much you want to pay in commissions so that you pay as little commission as possible, because over time, the amount of commission will add up. I would recommend the minimum to be around $1,000. So let's choose your account, then type in your top up amount, click next, then click submit. And with that, your brokerage account is ready to buy stocks. Go to our brokerage page by going to Invest, then clicking on DBS Vickers Online Trading. Click Next. So now we are in the DBS Vickers page. Let's go to Trade, then click on Place Order. For the settlement mode, choose Cash Upfront, settlement currency, leave it as SGD. And for the account, make sure that Cash Upfront is selected. For the market, choose Singapore, and you want to buy stocks. Then for the order type, choose limit order, order duration, good for today. Let's see what to buy. You might have recalled some random YouTuber talking about his portfolio. He mentioned that Mapletree Logistics is a good stock. So you go ahead and type in Mapletree Logistics. Let's say you want to buy the stock at its current price. In this case, it will be $1.75. So you go to price and you type in 175. And as for quantity, stocks in Singapore are sold in lots. Every lot is 100 stocks, and that means you can only buy in multiples of hundreds. So maybe we are feeling rich today, you want to buy 1 million lots. Just kidding, our account has only $1,000. So let's go to a calculator. Xiaoming has $1,000 and he wants to buy Mapletree at 175. How many stocks can Xiaoming buy? It shows 571. But remember that we can only buy in multiples of hundreds. So let's round it down to 500. So in the quantity section, we type in 500, then click preview order. Take note that there are more fees besides the commission fee, but they are all rather small. Like there's a bank clearing fee of 0.03%, SGX trading fee of 0.01%, and the GST 7%. Once you are satisfied with your order, just click confirm order and we just wait. If your price doesn't get matched, at the end of the day, your order will expire because this is a good for today order. But then if your price gets matched, congratulations, you bought your stocks and is now a proud shareholder of the stock. You have taken your first step in your journey to becoming rich. And that's all for today. I hope that this tutorial is useful to you. Let me know in the comments down below what kinds of other tutorials you want me to make. Like, share, and subscribe, as I'll be posting every Monday. See ya!